Hey, Stevie G here from Soul Jams Records.
This is Young Phantom YP.
This is Trigger.
My name is Chris Perry.
And you're watching The Lab TV.
We're here with The Lab TV.
And you're watching Lab TV.
At Urban Jungle.
Featuring inside an Urban Jungle.
At Urban Jungle.
Shout out to all the boys in the north side in Cork City. Brip!
Yeah.
Fucked around and fell in love with the music. Ain't been able to do nothing since. Life's so crazy, it helps me vent. You don't see from the inside.
What's up, guys? My name is Fortune Swanda, and you're watching The Lab TV, an online TV show that aims to promote youth talents and their business movements. Our special guest today is a young and talented music producer and video editor, Kankel. How are you, man?
Not too bad. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. Happy New Year, man.
Thanks
Happy
very
year.
Much.
Yeah. What are your highlights for 2015?
For 2015, I think kind of it was the first year that people kind of started to kind of recognizing and stuff like so. Yeah. Hopefully, yeah, it's kind of more the same for 2016. Yeah. I think the highlight was probably playing inside here in Urban Jungle. I think for this is about a month ago, I think, and it was very good fun. Like so,
good,
hopefully,
good.
Some more gigging now in 2016 mm-hmm. and take it from there.
So, any resolutions for
just to kind of release more music? I think like because I haven't released anything in about 2 years. I think at this stage, so just kind of getting some stuff out there and. Because I think on my SoundCloud there's like stuff from 3 years ago and other stuff and just to kind of get stuff out there and start working on more new stuff then I think.
Yeah. What's been holding you back?
Holding me back? Money, I think, would be the big thing. I need to get myself a job and get a proper studio together and kind of take it from there, I think.
Oh, I know. That's probably one of most people's problems.
Oh, anyway. Definitely. You need money to make money.
I know, yeah. How did you fall in love with the music production and all that?
I was actually fairly young. I was 12, I think, and I started getting this program. I got it. I remember I was in Portugal at the time, and all I wanted to do was go back and work on the program. I didn't enjoy myself over there at all.
Yeah.
And so I started using this thing, Dance EJ7, which was just kind of a really basic sort of music editing program. And from there, then I went to FL Studio, and from there on to Ableton, and just kind of gradually started building it up over the last 10 years.
So now you have to use Ableton?
Ableton now, yeah. But like kind of a mix,
I'd
rewire Ableton FL Studio so into it and stuff like and kind of use them both together.
Ableton seems so hard, man.
It's actually not what you kind of like. There's,
it's really cool, but it's tough to.
There's so much stuff you can do in it though as well. Like so, like say that you can just look up tutorials on YouTube. You can figure it all out from that, and just once you kind of get the hang of the basics, you're flying. Like
that's good. That's good. So, what type of music are you into producing?
Basically anything. Like I haven't really turned myself down really. Like as in, I'd find myself one day listening to house music, and I'd make a house song, and then the following day I'd be working on a hip hop song, and you know, kind of just switching between all of them really. Yeah. Like
because when I was on your SoundCloud, I can feel different types of music genres or something.
Yeah,
like the song that caught me the most was Driving in Summer. Or something.
Yeah.
That song was dope.
That was, I think that was about 3 or 4 years ago now, I think.
It's really good. Like,
thanks, it was just kind of, I remember I was feeling really sick and I stayed at home.
Yeah.
And I just kind of decided, you know what, I'm just going to try and just see if I can get a song out in the day or whatever. Yeah. And ended up just turning out the demo for that. And kind of people, I didn't really kind of just think that much of it. I was kind of just like putting it up, and but then people started coming on to, like, coming to me saying that they liked it. So
yeah, the song is
I think I'll definitely try and finish it, but yeah, I don't know.
Because I saw it's written demo and it's free for download.
Yeah.
I think it's good. It has potential, you know?
Yeah, yeah. I'd love to go and finish it, but I think at the moment now it's kind of, I'm working on so much stuff that, like, the worst thing to do would be to go back and go back 3 years and start from scratch. In the future, though, I will probably try and do something with it, I think.
Yeah. And what influences the names that you give to your songs?
Most of them kind of, like, I suppose, like, for Suns and stuff like that, for Suns and, like, Moons and stuff,
yeah.
I started with Suns, and it was actually a typo. It was just, I put an extra S in it by accident, and then I felt that I had this kind of Mott's vibe, and, you know, the double letters and stuff, and I was just like, yeah, I'll throw it together and just put it there, and then there was this production competition that was being done by Monto and Cert One, this Break Bread kind of thing, it was called, and for that, one of the requirements was you had to remake or, like, take elements from an old song and then put some new stuff together. I thought Moons would be the logical kind of name then for the follow-up to it, like, so.
Alright, no, take care now. Yeah, because I was there, I was like, what inspires this type of names, you know?
Yeah, like, it's moon, just sun, a lot of it is going to be kind of just from reading and stuff, like, just kind of finding one word or, you know, kind of that kind of just grabs you, and then I just take them down on my phone then, and when I'm exporting a song, I'll just look through the list of names
that's good. Are you working with any local artists right now, or
I'm working on stuff with Chris Powell, right, who we've done a couple of, like, a ton of tracks together, but we're still kind of trying to figure out, you know, the style and stuff like that, but we're working on stuff under the name Man Made at the moment, and I'm hopefully going to be calling over to him later this week to kind of get some beats together and stuff.
You're really a busy man, yeah? So, on video editing,
yeah,
how did you fall in love with that?
Through college, really. Like, I initially kind of started getting into multimedia stuff, like, from the music thing. I was kind of hoping, you know, maybe if I figured out all this graphic design stuff and all that, maybe that'll complement the music. Once I got into college, then I realized that the video editing was something that I'd like to do maybe separately to it and stuff, so I kind of just started just working away with animation and editing footage and stuff like that.
Cool. Talking about video editing, the song, the video that you made for Tales of the Terrace.
It was a bit of a weird one. Atari actually got onto me, Atari Jones, who's featured on the song with Chris Power. He got onto me saying, oh, I have this really good idea for a video. It was initially for another song that they were doing, but they felt that Tales of the Terrace, you know, suited it better, which it definitely does. Sent me footage of these, and, like, it was a model sort of shoot from, I think, last year or something, possibly. So he sent me that, and he was just like, just edit that whatever way you can, and, you know, kind of just make it like a visual aid for the track itself. And I just kind of decided then that I'd make it look like they were high off their heads, just running around the place. Do you know what I mean?
Because I was wondering, are those ladies from...
they're not from Cork.
They're local.
Sadly, they're not from Cork.
You know?
Yeah.
Okay, I see. Because the video is actually brilliant. I think the video is brilliant.
Thanks, cheers.
It suits well to them.
Yeah, like, you know? I think if you have any sort of girls along with an Atari Jones song, I think it kind of tends to suit it, you know what I mean? That man's music is made for girls to dance to it.
Yeah, I've seen the... Even on Twitter, I think I've seen a few clips of models dancing to his songs.
Just random girls would be sending Chris just videos of them just with, like, selfie cameras or something, dancing to the song.
It's wonderful.
It's amazing how much it's caught
the
on.
The impact that it's getting out there.
They're not sending me the videos, though, which is unfortunate.
I know,
That'll come in time, hopefully.
Retire. You never know. And your video editing, are you... Are you making an official, like it's part of your business or?
I could definitely see it going that way in the future. Yeah. At the moment now, it's kind of, you know, doing odd jobs and kind of for people and just kind of.
Or getting your name out
yeah,
there.
Yeah, getting my name out there and just kind of even like for helping friends and stuff. Like the main reason I did the thing for Atari Jones and Chris is because I wanted to be involved in that project. You know what I mean? It wasn't a case of like trying to kind of get my name out there. I was just kind of like, this is a really nice song. I'll definitely try and do something for it. Yeah. So, but yeah, in the future, I'd definitely be up for doing something similar.
Have you done some videos as well?
I've a few of them, but kind of they're all kind of college projects and stuff. Second clips and stuff like that. I'd be well up for kind of just exploring that kind of thing a lot more. I think
that's good. That's good because I know a lot of people right now that will want to have videos. To get videos, the music. Because there are not so many video editors or videographers.
Brendan of Feel Good Lost, who, like, I'm a huge fan of him. He's a big influence. He did the video for Hozier and all this kind of stuff. Like, he's huge now and stuff. And if I was to do kind of video editing, I'd have to say he'd probably be my main influence. He was the kind of reason that I kind of discovered a lot of the music that I'm into now, just from looking at his music videos back in the day and stuff. Yeah, so
that's brilliant. That's brilliant. Mm. And talking about. About, you talked about DJing.
Yeah.
You DJ as well.
I have done. I kind of just try and do whatever comes to me, really. I had a gig in here about a month ago and stuff, but like they're very sort of odd so far. I'm kind of still trying to, you know, get my name out there and stuff and just kind of playing odd things, really.
Well, what do you play? What do you order?
It kind of depends. Like sometimes I'd kind of go housey with it, or like it really depends on the venue. When I was playing here, I was playing mostly, you know, hip hop and kind of weird experimental stuff bit of jazz and funk. And stuff like this, everything really.
Is it something that you like do just for fun, or you're looking up to doing it?
Like at the moment now, I kind of just like the main reason I take most gigs nowadays is because I'm still kind of trying to figure out DJing and kind of still learning the craft and stuff. So basically, any opportunity I get to get behind a set of decks and, you know, kind of play around with them even for an hour or two, I'm going to do it and just kind of like learn from that, because I don't have the money to afford like an actual setup at the moment. I remember I did a DJ competition about a year and a half ago. It was Battle of the DJ. It was like a UCC thing. My main reason for doing it was to get behind a set of decks, but I was just thrown into this competition, didn't know like basically how to do anything, and just kind of had to do it all on the fly, like kind of figuring out all the buttons and stuff. And like I think I came second, which is pretty good. It was the UCC DJ Society that were running it, so it was all kind of up and coming DJs and stuff. Like they were all in the same position, so it was definitely a really good way of kind of getting used to kind of DJing and stuff like that. I think
that's good. That's good. In terms of artists in Ireland, what do you think of the music?
In general,
from hip hop to whatever dance, whatever type of music that people are doing right now.
I think it's kind of it's an exciting place at the moment. I think definitely, there's a lot of big acts kind of releasing albums and releasing good material and stuff, and kind of getting their name out there. Like a lot of the cutting heads people, they're doing their part in Cork as well. They're building up the kind of scene and stuff. And there's people like Toby Kerr. I've heard his new album, and that is going to be absolutely huge, I'm sure.
Where's the best one?
Sorry.
Where is the best? Is it here?
It's based in Cork, but it's just, there's a lot of good stuff coming out and stuff, and I think it's kind of an exciting time for Cork, really. There's a lot of kind of acts kind of working together and kind of getting stuff out, so.
Yeah. A lot of artists, when they start getting a recognition, they move.
Yeah.
What do you think makes that?
I think kind of, it's just the lack of any club staying open for longer than a year that will support the music, you know? I think, I don't know, it's just so hard to kind of build up a scene in Cork where there's so little, like, I don't know kind of how many people there are that are actually supporting it, you know? I think kind of people are starting to get behind it now, so like that's kind of why it's kind of becoming so exciting these days. But I think the reason people move away is to kind of get gigs elsewhere. Like people move to like Brussels or stuff or Berlin, just to kind of get the gigs over there and kind of, I suppose, break out of the Irish thing as well, where you're just holed up in Ireland for your life and you can't break it out, and you're just considered an Irish artist and that's it alone.
What makes that? Is it lack of support from local, or it's just there's just a stigma that's around?
It's not lack of support, because the support is there, but I think it's just I think it's more a case of people, like, until the Cutting Heads Collective, there wasn't really a huge collective in Cork that was, you know, kind of supporting people together, and everyone contributes to it and stuff. So, like, beforehand, it was kind of everyone for himself, every man for himself, kind of, you know. So, like, people were releasing records, and then you'd have one or two people pushing them, and then everyone else pushing their own records. So, you know, it just kind of made, like, 10 records that could have been good if everyone just pushed them. It was 10 records that were being pushed individually and they weren't getting to the same place, I think. So like, it was, people are kind of getting stuck that way, and they're kind of, you know, just kind of getting to a certain audience and not being able to kind of break out and do their own thing, kind of.
All right. That sounds great. Because I'm a fan of local music right now, you know.
And
I want to see people pushing. I want to see people like Trigger managing to fill out opera houses.
Oh, that would be absolutely unbelievable.
Because I think it's possible. I just think that there's something that we're missing.
Trigger's music is absolutely unbelievable. Like,
because when you hear his album, it's solid.
It's really quality. Like, I've said it to him before, like, most Cork hip hop and stuff, like, you know, kind of, it's hard to get the beats and the Cork kind of accent to kind of, you know, go together well. But I think, like, acts like Trigger and even GMC and stuff, like, they like, they've somehow managed to kind of make it gel together nicely and kind of work cohesively, which is not an easy thing to do, like.
I know. So, yeah. Hopefully something will happen anyway.
Yeah.
Hopefully.
I think we're kind of on the verge of something happening. Do you know, like, I can definitely feel like people are getting excited and people are kind do you know, kind of starting to kind of get things moving and stuff. So hopefully 2016 will be interesting.
I know. What's your prediction for it?
For this year, I think definitely just kind of release new music and stuff, and prediction. For myself,
from you, and also for the whole scene, the whole music industry,
hopefully for me, I think release more music and kind of build it up that way. But I think in general, I'd say this place is going to do very well, I'd say, because people are kind of starting to kind of get their audience and kind of build it up that way. But I think, yeah, there's a couple of exciting gigs already booked for, like, January. Like, Illa J's coming in January, which will be very good. And the Cutting Heads people have a lot of gigs coming up as well and stuff. So hopefully, it should be a pretty exciting year, I'd say.
Man, thank you very much for coming.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much for coming, man. We had a good time.
Absolutely,